I'm Trinity.
And I'm Katie.
And I'm so excited to be back with you guys this week. Being on screen on FaceTime just wasn't cutting it for me, so I'm so excited to be back in the studio with you guys.
We are all excited for you to be back, Trinity.
Yeah.
Okay, first we have a little announcement. So the Media Center is asking people for broken iPads. So if you have a broken iPad, bring it down to the Media Center before school ends.
And you know who else is really excited to be back this week?
Carl.
Carl with Weekday Update. But first, we have the BIG broadcast and Tyler's Movie Corner. And I actually watched one of Tyler's movies that he suggested, Three Billboards, and it was an amazing movie. It made you feel all emotions. I was crying at one point. I was laughing. I was happy. I was angry. So really, the movies that Tyler suggests, I highly suggest watching. They are amazing. So let's check it out.
All right, cool. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another fantastic episode of the BIG Broadcast. I'm your host, the BIG Caesar, bringing you the knowledge and news of the loved art form we know as music. Today in trending music news, famous actor, rapper, and film writer Donald Glover has released a new single titled This Is America. The song included a very striking video as well, showing Glover dancing around a parking lot while a lot of tragedies happen around him. The video is said to be a statement of a theory stated that America is filled with horrible things that happen to certain groups of people and that the media always seems to sweep it right under the rug and distract us with a lot of irrelevant things like viral dances and drama among celebrities. Famous singer Adele has praised Glover for the video and claims that she adores the artist and is aware of his greatness. The single hints that Glover is most likely working on new music and he is also set to tour with Ray Shremmerd in September. So, how do you feel? Do you think the new single is really powerful? Or do you think it's probably just another form of propaganda? Let me know your thoughts when you see me. Controversial legendary rapper Kanye West has been banned from many radio stations because of the comments he made on TMZ, stating that he believes American slavery was a choice. They say they're tired of West and do not want to give him a platform anymore. He's taken it too far, sources claim. Kanye has been under fire the last few weeks for his remarks to the public and on Twitter. He returned to Twitter after he took a break to focus on music, his health, and of course, his family. He spent the first few days sending encouragement to all of his fans, but later came under fire for showing his support for our current president and of course, his comments on slavery. Personally, I don't have a problem with Mr. West, and I think he's entitled to his own opinion. But I do believe he should probably educate himself on slavery first. It's a very touchy and sensitive topic to many, and I suggest you learn more about it before you make such a bold statement on it. But hey, Kanye, you will still be a legend in my heart. And now, on to music reviews for your local crews. I received a lot of submissions over the weekend, so bear with me during these next couple of weeks. Our first submission is for 612 Crew coming from Farmington, Minnesota. Roll the clip out. I just bought a foreign, so I draw the top. She said that she loved me, I know that she does not. Counting of this camp, I'm counting of this squad. Pulled off in a foreign, I just let the lock. I just bought a foreign, so I draw the top. She said that she loved me, I know that she does not. Counting of this cake, counting of this squad. Pulled off in a foreign, I just let the lock. My. Well, 612, I have to say you guys have a whole lot of talent, and I can tell you guys really take your time when you guys edit. The only thing I would say is that a few members should probably work on making more words rhyme when working on your verses. Even though the flow is good, a lot of you guys use the same words to rhyme. It's not bad, but there should be a lot of variety with your words. But besides all that, I'd give you about a 9 out of 10 on the BIG scale. Our next submission is coming in for Young Gravy, from Rochester, Minnesota. Or the clip out. Hop in, walk out, pipe up, clock out, new wrist, watch out, look, stress and knock out. Hop in, walk out, pipe up, clock out, new wrist, watch out, look, that's a knockout. Hop in, walk out, pipe up, clock out, new wrist, watch out, look, that's a knockout. Hop in, walk out, pipe up, clock out,
that's a knockout.
Mr. Gravy, just like the last bunch, I think you're super talented also. You have a lot of good numbers, and I heard you from the radio, and personally, I think you have the potential to propel Minnesota to where it should be in terms of music. So for that, I'd give you a 9.5 out of 10 on the BIG scale. Oh, by the way, I would suggest working on your verses also. Even though you're super versatile, I feel like I don't know exactly what your point is besides flexing, which actually isn't that bad at all, but you have really catchy hooks, and I think you have a team full of good producers, so keep up the good work. Keep grinding, Gravy. Well, that's all for today, folks. Remember to stay positive, stay groovy, and stay as smooth as a smoothie. It's your host. Thanks for watching.
What's up, guys? Tyler back again for another episode of Tyler's Movie Corner. And today we're going to be talking about what I believe to be the most underrated Coen Brothers film, A Serious Man. Let's get going. This film follows Larry Gopnik, played by Michael Stuhlbarg. He's a down-on-his-luck college professor and family man living in the suburbs of 1960s Minnesota. His life begins to spiral out of control, seemingly all at once. This includes his wife requesting a divorce, his tenure being threatened by anonymous blackmail letters, one of his students persistently trying to bribe him for a better grade, owing a substantial amount of money to a record subscription, all while his son experiences similar problems, such as struggling to pay back borrowed money to the school bully. Larry begins to question what he possibly could have done to experience so much misfortune, so he seeks out professional help from three rabbis to help him regain control of his life. I gotta say, this is just flat out one of the most bizarre movies I've ever seen. The Coens have created a movie that's fairly simple on the surface, but filled to the brim with deeper meanings and interpretations if you look for them. This film deals heavily with the concepts of chaos, uncertainty, duality, and unpredictability. Each scene presents a moral dilemma for Larry. As the events unfold, his sanity begins to crumble. Larry repeatedly says, "What's going on?" as each event unfolds.
What's going on? What's going on?
Tell me what's going on.
What's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
This constant state of confusion showcases just how little control he has over his life, which is one of the big themes of the movie. In typical Coen Brothers fashion, this movie has a good deal of dark comedy mixed in the form of absurd situations.
I didn't ask for any records.
To receive the monthly main selection, you do nothing.
That's right, I haven't done anything.
Yes, that's why you receive the monthly main selection.
I just can't stress enough how great Michael Stuhlbarg is in this role. He's one of my favorite rising actors, also known for supporting roles in The Shape of Water, Lincoln, Men in Black 3, and Fargo Season 3. Here he's perfect as an average man being pushed to the limit by the struggles of his life. As I said, there are many deep religious and philosophical themes at play here. Larry begins to question if what is happening to him is a form of punishment by God, even though he constantly utters the phrase,
"I didn't do anything,"
when faced with bad luck. Some interpretations of the film say this is exactly Larry's problem, as by doing nothing, his inaction is just as bad as negative action. I will say, the ending of this film is very polarizing, and it may anger some people. It's the kind of conclusion that seems like it comes out of nowhere, but if one is paying close enough attention to the overall theme of unpredictability at play throughout the movie, I think you'll enjoy it quite a bit. So this is yet another odd, hilarious, and often bleak film by the Coen brothers. It's one of their most underrated outings and one of the most meticulously crafted movies I've ever seen, and I don't think it got the attention it deserved. It's the kind of movie that challenges concepts that aren't normally questioned, and it's an incredibly bold and important movie for it. It's currently on Netflix, and I highly suggest you check it out before it leaves. So that'll be it for this episode of Tyler's Movie Corner. Thanks for watching.
Thanks, Chris and Tyler. As usual, you guys did great, and each episode keeps getting better.
Yeah, and remember to watch Tyler's movie, as I am sure it was amazing. And as you guys may have heard, the Met Gala was just this last week, and we have Weekday Update to tell you a little bit more about it.
Weekday Update with Kinley Collier, Shayna Dice, and Carl Azuz.
Good morning, Farmington. I'm Shayna Dice.
I'm Kinley Collier.
And I'm Carl Asmus. Welcome to Weekday Update.
On Monday, May 7th, the annual 47th Met Gala happened. If you don't know what the Met Gala is, it is a formally called the Costume Institute Gala and is also known as the Met Ball. It is an annual fundraising gala for the benefit of the Metropolitan Museum of Art Costume Institute in New York City. This year's theme was Holy Bodies and Catholic Imagination. Some of the celebrities that appeared took our breaths away. Rihanna showed up with her Pope-inspired look, Katy Perry in gigantic white feather wings, Ariana Grande's dress had the Sistine Chapel on it, Blake Lively actually arrived in a party bus because her dress was so big and she's being called the Met Queen. The new and gorgeous couple Shawn Mendes and Hailey Baldwin are catching everyone's eyes, and Cardi B looked amazing as always. There were even more celebrities who shook everyone there, but there were just too many to mention, and some I don't want to mention because they didn't match the theme, but it's fine. But everyone looked amazing, and we can't wait until next year.
More about the Met Gala. I have two more outfits to talk about. First outfit, Kendall and Kylie Jenner. Kylie wore a plain black dress, and Kendall wore a white jumpsuit. Apparently, they didn't follow the theme of the Met Gala, and people were angry with their outfit choices. Next person is Selena Gomez. I'm not really talking about her outfit. I'm talking more about her ridiculous fake tan. Who thought giving Selena a fake tan would look good? She's already stunning without it, and the tan was just not a bright idea. Also, try to see if you can spot Kylie Jenner's Band-Aid on her arm.
This week into the news, a truck full of liquid chocolate has overturned on a motorway in Poland, spilling 12 tons of stuff all over the road. It is not clear as of yet what caused the tanker truck to overturn onto the side of the road and into the median, and ultimately where it was headed. By the time the cleanup crews arrived, the liquid had already begun to solidify, making the operation even more difficult, said local police. I really want to be there so I can eat some of the chocolate. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Carl.
I'm Shayna.
And I'm Kinley. Now it's time for Luke's Lifts.
I'm Luke from Luke's Lifts. Part of my job here at Farmington 360 is to help you get fit. Not all of us have access to a gym. But this workout video is to help you get fit at home. And here to help me are some of my friends. If you're skeptical about trying this exercise, just know that it's 100% Luke approved. For our first exercise, we're gonna do step-ups. So grab something to step up on. And let's get started. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5, 6, 7, and 8. If this is too easy for you, feel free to pick up speed. Alright, the next exercise. It's going to be body squats.
Ready? Begin.
When you wake up tomorrow, you'll be all alone.
Feel free to pick up speed.
And I have quickly outgrown. I wanted to stay, but I just couldn't do it. Couldn't stand there.
For our final exercise today, we're going to do something that encompasses breathing and stability. So what we're going to do, we're going to take the thing that we were stepping up on, put it on your arms like this, keep them straight, keep them level, then we're going to bounce on our ball, and then control our breathing. Ready? You just finished a loose lifts home workout video. Remember, it's not about getting skinny, it's about getting fit. Thanks for watching, see you next week.
Hey Farmington, I'm Ethan, and it's time for It's Not Our Weather. You might be asking yourself, well, why do you see Mexico up again? Well, I'm not the only one doing weather this week.
Oh, hey Farmington, I'm Jack Bombach, and I'm going to be helping today. Today we've got Zach Kiss, a high of 75 and a low of 49. We've got Nuevo Laredo, high of 97 and a low of 72. And Villa Hermanos, high of 94 and a low of 73.
They got a high of 79 and a low of 67. And then right. Over here in Kamakumo, they got a high of 89 and a low of 70 today.
So that's all for it. Have a great Tiger Day.
Now it's time for Travels and Ethan's Expeditions.
Good morning, Farmington. I'm Trinity Buttruff, and I'm back with Trinity's Travels and Ethan's Expeditions. The last couple of weeks, you may have noticed that I was gone. I actually traveled to Japan, so I have prepared a video for you guys to let you guys in on a couple of things that I did, so I hope you enjoy it. You made plans, and I made problems. We were sleeping back to bed. This day wasn't built to last, yeah. Good on paper, picture perfect. Chase the high too far too fast. Pick a white fence, we'll be painted black. And I wish you would hurt me harder than I hurt you. And I wish you wouldn't wait for me, but you always do. I've been hoping somebody loves you in the ways I couldn't. Somebody's taking care. I hope you enjoyed my photos and videos from Japan. It was by far my favorite place. I know I said the same thing about Italy, but seriously, you guys, Japan is so worth it. It's one of the best places I've ever been. Beautiful country with amazing people. And I mean, the food was a little iffy. You have to like seafood, but the ramen is amazing. Like seriously, the ramen is awesome. So I hope you guys enjoyed it and have a great week.
That was great, Trinity.
Thank you. Thank you. I worked pretty hard on it, and Japan was by far, seriously, the best place I've ever been. It was the trip of a lifetime. I couldn't be more grateful for the opportunity that I had to go there.
It seemed like a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was. It was.
Now, another little announcement. Today is the last day to order yearbooks online. So if you want to order a yearbook online, go to a link that Mr. Berg posted on Schoology.
And if you want a chance to look as beautiful as everybody else at the Met Gala, prom is this weekend, and remember to please be safe. Please be safe. That's all.
Now, would you believe?
Would you believe?
Would you believe?
I've got a hybrid.
And Carson's feature.
Would you believe?
Would you believe?
Would you believe?
I've got a hybrid.
I'm making a map for Spanish.
I'm doing math homework.
What kind?
Algebra.
I'm in math. I don't have a hybrid, but I'm ahead, so I'm flexing out.
So right now I'm doing a Spanish project in Espanol 1, and after I'm done, I'm planning on going on the golf game out in Found Valley today. And I'll probably plan on playing on my 3 computers when I get home.
I'm watching Twitch, Ninja. Season 4 just came out on Fortnite.
I usually like work on my homework. Or I watch my boy Ninja on Twitch.
What are you doing?
Watching Ninja.
Ninja did win that game.
Yay! I'm doing my homework for Spanish.
In spite of recent events, your view of the airline industry may be tarnished. I got a chance to pick the brain of Delta pilot Christopher Tadovich about the safety of flying commercially as opposed to driving a car.
I think flying commercially is much safer because when you look at the statistics of amount of deaths and accidents per person driving, it's much higher than the amount of deaths and accidents on commercial airline aircraft. Especially if you look at the daily news, there's accidents, car accidents, and deaths every day, whereas in the airline industry, there's rarely any deaths or accidents, and if you do hear them, if there are, you do hear about them. And, you know, recently there's only been a couple in the last year, it seems like.
With two major accounts of aircraft malfunctioning in such rapid succession, you'd be led to think that the airliner you are flying on will, more than likely, suffer catastrophic failure. But you'd be wrong.
If you look at the news stories aircraft accidents over the last 5 years, it'll just show you that in the last 5 years there has been very few accidents or incidents for that matter. And the fact that two of them just happened back to back is just very random. In fact, in the last 5 years, I think there's just been very few people that have even died from an accident, and it's been mostly from foreign carriers. But in the U.S., I think that was like one of the first deaths in a long time.
Since that was from a pilot's perspective, some people still may be skeptical about the safety of flying commercially. Luckily for you, I also got an opportunity to get some answers from a passenger's point of view.
I think flying commercially is pretty safe. They have flotation devices in case something does happen, but on top of that, they'll always make announcements and tell you if they think they're gonna go over like some rough winds, or they have like the seatbelt sign, and so I think they take some good precautions to make sure they're safe.
So there you have it. Flying commercially isn't even a fraction as dangerous as the mainstream media will have you believe. You heard it straight from the horse's mouth. This has been Carson Tadovich, reporting for Farmington 360.
Well, thank you, Carson, for that feature. I actually strictly only fly Delta, just because that's what I'm comfortable with. So I actually found it really cool to find out that Carson's dad is a Delta Airlines pilot.
I know, he's like your hero.
I mean, yeah, pretty much. He's gotten me everywhere safe, so that's pretty awesome. And you may have noticed that this last week, we had for the 11th and 12th graders, we had the mock car crash, which was pretty emotional and pretty hard-hitting. And for the 10th graders, they had the reality store. Mm-hmm. So we have a little bit more about the reality store for those who don't really know what it is. So let's check it out.
Hi guys, I'm Katie and I'm down here at the reality store for sophomores, where people are learning how to finance their money for the future.
So how are you enjoying the reality store?
I mean, it's fun. It's like interesting to see how much you actually have to pay for just living life, basically.
So the reality store is a great opportunity for our students to see what the real world will be like. So it's an opportunity for all these cool people that are here today from the community to come in and meet with our students and to explain a little bit more about all the different aspects of the financial life that students are going to lead. We also have opportunities to talk about things like the table that I'm at, which is talking about charity and giving money or giving your time as a volunteer. As a super important thing other than just the dollars and cents of earning and spending money out there in the world. But this is a great chance for our sophomores to think, all right, what do I need to do while I'm at Farmington High to get myself ready for the realities that are out there, the financial realities that are out there, and that's what we do.
So what is your name and what are you doing here at this event?
My name is Chad Layden and I am volunteering at the transportation booth.
So what do you think of this event?
I think this event is a very good idea, very insightful for a lot of the young people. We've had a lot of good questions today and a lot of people learning how to use a check register.
Do you think this event should be done more in the future?
I do. I think it should be done at least once a year, if not maybe even twice a year.
Okay, thank you.
Well, thank you, Katie, for shooting that. And that's all we have for you guys today on Farmington 360. I'm Trinity.
And I'm Katie.
And we're going to leave you with some footage from the mock car crash. And beware, it is pretty emotional and pretty hard. So if you feel uncomfortable, please don't feel like you need to watch it. But please enjoy.
So have a good weekend.
Yes, have a good weekend.
It's a beautiful May evening after prom when something goes terribly wrong.
As you can see, first responders are still not even on the scene. It takes a while from that first call, 911 call, to when you're going to get somebody on scene. And it is very traumatizing if you are the one in the vehicle or having to deal with this, waiting. You watching it doesn't seem like a long time, but for those on scene, it feels like hours.
Julie, where are they?
Ready? One, two, three.
Sure.
Before morning, three of our sons would be dead because of the choices of one young man who drove under the influence of alcohol, was talking on his cell phone, reaching for a DVD, and driving too fast.
She said, Matthew and Justin are dead. And I remember I laid my phone down and I cried out in prayer, dear Jesus, help me. I didn't know if I could continue driving, let alone live. You can make a difference. The choice is yours. The reason we take the time to do this is to give you this experience and hopefully you can learn from it and really pull together and make sure that people around you aren't making those decisions.
Try to get ahead or help someone who